So our education leaders, school heads, teachers, researchers, students, participants, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon from Bangkok, Thailand. Welcome to the orientation session for the 2023 CIMEO Australia Education Links Award, or the SAELA. Last week, we launched the call for applications for SAELA 2023. Today, as you begin your project proposals under the theme Fostering Inclusion Through Digital Technology, we will be discussing the application process for this year's SAELA and clarify some of your questions. I am Emil John Columna Sintilias, Policy and Planning Specialist of CIMEO Secretariat, and I will be orienting you on the what, who, why, when, where, and how of SAELA 2023. To commence our activity, may I call on the Deputy Director for Program and Development of CIMEO Secretariat, Mr. John Arnold Shena, for the opening remarks. Mr. John, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Kun Emil. Education leaders, teachers, researchers, students, esteemed guests, participants, ladies and gentlemen. A warm welcome to all of you to this orientation session for the CIMEO Australia Links Award 2023, or SAELA 2023 in short. We are delighted to have you all here today, not only because of your interest in this program, but more importantly, because you believe that you can contribute to the improvement of the quality of education in your community, in your country, and in the region. SAELA is an initiative that highlights the strong collaboration between CIMEO and Australia, one of our associate member countries. This collaboration is a testament to our commitment to our common goal of providing quality education to our learners in Southeast Asia. On behalf of CIMEO and CIMEO Secretariat, led by our Director Datuk Dr. Habiba Abdul Rahim, I wish to extend our gratitude to our associate member country, Australia, and our staunch partner in this endeavor. Your support and collaboration are evidence that working together leads to the achievement of our goals and objectives. This year, SAELA is adopting the theme Fostering Inclusion Through Digital Technology in Southeast Asia to bring to fore the important role of digital technology in improving access to and enhancing quality of education. More particularly, the theme is a recognition of the potential of technology to empower the marginalized and the vulnerable. Hence, this year's SAELA's theme is not just focusing on technology for technology's sake, it is also a call to action. It is an invitation to think creatively, to propose projects that have the potential to transform lives and to be part of a movement that is shaping the future of our education in the region. We are looking for innovative project proposals that leverage digital technologies to promote access to education and educational resources, enhance foundational and digital literacy, and improve teaching and learning processes. Acknowledging the potential of SAELA to spur innovations, we are conducting this orientation session today to help everyone understand and better prepare their proposals. In this session, you will learn about the application process, the criteria for project proposals, and the expectations from the participants. In doing so, we are hoping to build up excitement and encourage more participation. So we invite you to be part of this journey, to be the catalysts for change, and to champion the cause of inclusive education in our region. Thank you for joining us today, and we look forward to your active participation in SAELA 2023. Together, we can harness the power of digital technology to break down barriers, foster inclusion, and create a brighter future for all. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. John, for underscoring the relevance of this year's theme. SAELA 2023 will not be successful, as Kun John mentioned, without the support of our associate member country and partner, the Australian Government Department of Education. To give our remarks to this activity, may I call on Ms. Rachel Treglown from the Multilateral Policy International Division of the Australian Government Department of Education. Rachel, the floor is yours. Apologies, Rachel. It seems like we can't hear you. Okay, we cannot hear you. Apologies for that. Okay. Would that what is okay. I think we are experiencing some technical problems right now with the audio. So we'll go back to Rachel in a few minutes. But for now, we can first go to the direct attention to the screen for the instructions for the question and answer later. So if you're on your screen right now, please send in your questions at the link https://link.cimeo.org/2023-sa-ella/questions or scan the QR code that you flash in the screen as we await. Okay, so is Rachel ready for the message? Hello, Rachel. Okay, I think she's ready. Miss Rachel of Department of Education of Australia.
Hello, can you hear me?
Okay,
now?
Yes, now. Thank you. Sorry, yours.
What a wonderful start as we're talking about technology and education, the barriers that we can face here. Thank you very much for your kind words and for your patience as we work through the technology. I would like to acknowledge that I am calling in from Canberra, which is Ngunnawal and Ngambri country, and extend my respects to First Nations people of Australia and the continuing connection to land, sea and community. Thank you very much for having me here today. It is a great pleasure and a great honour to be joining this orientation session. Australia is delighted to co-sponsor the Sa-Ella 2023 and all of the great work that is being done. Thank you to all of the academics, researchers, students, teachers, and esteemed guests for your interest in this program. And thank you in advance for your proposals, which we look forward to reading as part of the application process. The work of the program is so important and has we have been delighted to sponsor some wonderful projects over the last 10 years of Sa-Ella. And we look forward to seeing what comes out of this year's program, which has such an important and timely theme. Thanks very much. Back to you, Emil John.
So now we proceed. I hope you're all excited to learn more about the Cimeo Australia Education Links Award. But before we begin, once again, please direct your attention to the screen. If you have any questions, kindly input them to the Google form through this link, link.cimeo.org/2023-sa-ella/questions, or you can scan the QR code. This will also be available in the chat box of our YouTube live stream. With this, let us start and let me walk you through the application process for Sa-Ella 2023 with the theme Fostering Inclusion Through Digital Technology. So what is the Cimeo Australia Education Links Award? So as we all know, the Government of Australia, one of Cimeo's associate member countries, has been actively supporting Cimeo member countries since 1973. And one of the flagship partnerships between Cimeo and the Australian Government Department of Education is the Cimeo Australia Education Links Award, or Sa-Ella, which was launched in 2013. Sa-Ella seeks to offer opportunities to individuals or education institutions to propose and implement education-related projects, activities, or policy initiatives aligned with the annual theme. These initiatives aim to strengthen collaboration and partnerships between Southeast Asia and Australia. Now, what are the objectives of Sa-Ella? Sa-Ella first aims to facilitate the development and implementation of effective educational projects and initiatives through partnerships among countries, organizations, and communities. These project proposals also aim to showcase cooperation in education, training, and research activities, and emphasize their value in fostering stronger people-to-people and institutional connections. So we want to see cooperation and collaboration among countries, perhaps organizations, and of course, communities. And finally, Saela aims to create a platform for sharing and learning about new ideas in educational cooperation. We envision that these projects contribute to enhancing the quality of life in the region in the long term. What is the theme for 2023, Saela? It is fostering inclusion through digital technology. We believe that digital technology can be a critical tool for fostering inclusion, especially in our region, where there are variances and nuances on the reach of digital technology. This year's theme will look at innovative project proposals that seek to leverage digital technologies in promoting access to education and educational resources, enhancing foundational and digital literacy, and improving teaching and learning processes. Ultimately, the project proposals should empower marginalized communities and vulnerable populations towards building more inclusive education systems in your countries and in the region. This proposal should highlight digital technology as a potent tool in breaking down barriers to inclusion and providing opportunities for every individual to thrive. So these are the details, general details for Saela 2023. So let us listen carefully. I know there's this already in our webpage, but once again, let us listen to this. Okay, so interested applicants must submit a written proposal outlining their concept, implementation plan, and how the grant funds will be utilized. This will be discussed further in detail in our next slides. One winner will be selected and awarded a grant of 10,000 Australian dollars to carry out activities related to the winning project or idea. The grant will be provided in three tranches based on the agreed timeline and deliverables. In addition to the grant of 10,000 Australian dollars, the winner will also receive a plaque of recognition, and we will fly him or her to Bangkok, Thailand to receive the award during the 46th CIMEO High Officials Meeting this November. The shortlisted candidates will receive a certificate of recognition. And applicants whose proposals meet the minimum requirements, including relevance to the theme and adherence to submission instructions, will receive a certificate of participation. Please take note that participation to Saela 2023 is entirely free. Okay, so I hope this gets your energy in applying to Saela. So who can apply to Saela 2023? Saela welcomes proposals from education leaders, educators, teachers, researchers, and even students representing educational institutions at all levels. This means it can come from basic education, higher education, TVET. Applicants must be a citizen of a CIMEO member country, so from Brunei Darussalam, Cambodia, Indonesia, Laos PDR, Malaysia, Myanmar, Philippines, Singapore, Thailand, Vietnam, and Timor-Leste. The applicants must not have received any CIMEO award in the past years. Please also note that applicants should not be employed by any private company. And CIMEO Secretariat, of course, and CIMEO Regional Center staff, as well as their immediate family members, are also not eligible to apply for Saela. Okay, so we're down to our next slide. How to prepare the proposal. So I hope you're all ready for that. Okay, so use the provided 2023 Saela proposal template, which will be discussed in detail in a few. It's available for download on the website or by requesting it via email address saela@cimeo.org. The proposal must be written using the English language, and keep the proposal under 3 pages of A4 paper in total, using Calibri with a font size of 11. So you'll be reading, please keep it concise, brief, simple. Get your point across so that we can read your proposals. And then the template includes the proponent and proposal information. Okay, let us discuss the parts of the template. So let's proceed. This is the template that you will find in our website. Later, we will send you the link of the template. So the first part is the proponent information. So the proponent information includes the title and full name, your nationality, the country, your organization or institution, your position, the mailing address, your email address, and of course your mobile WhatsApp number so we can reach out to you with any clarifications, and of course if you're the winner, of course. Next slide, we go to the proposal information. The meat, the heart of your submission is the proposal information. So the proposal information includes the title of the project. So we hope it to be more creative, more innovative, catchy. You would also want to know the status of the project. If this is a new idea or you are building on an existing project which you would want to scale up or perhaps try new things. But of course, we want to be original and innovative still. After that, we would want you to have 250 words for the background and rationale, detailing the context in which your proposed project will be developed. The brief description of the project will provide a quick discussion of what is the project all about. So we would want to be concise and simple. Keep the description to 400 words or less. So get that computer typing already and already summarize the content of your proposal. Now, next slide. The template also includes the objectives of your project. So what do you want to achieve? What does your project want to achieve? It would also be good for you to identify your target recipients and project duration, of course, in months, so translated in months. And write a brief description on the cooperation between Southeast Asia and Australia. What does this mean? So this means how you will ensure that other Southeast Asian countries, not all perhaps, some countries, neighboring countries, and Australia can be involved in this project, or how we can use their expertise, or how you can share these lessons to our partners in Australia and other Southeast Asian countries. Next, you should list down the expected outputs and determine its success indicators and the possible risks in achieving this output. So for example, as you can see on your screen, you have here your output. Expected outputs are teachers trained on digital literacy. So your success indicator is 25 teachers trained by July 2024. So your assumption is that you will be able to conduct this on time if there are no overlapping schedules for the teachers, especially, for example, in the Philippines, it might be the start of the school year, so that it might be overlapping. So you have to ensure that the schedules are in line so that they can participate in your planned training. Next slide. You also would want to see your implementation plan, which includes your proposed activities, timelines, and how you will utilize the $10,000 grant. For example, for January 2023, you have a one-day workshop, and the details of this, you have your venue, your meals, and honorarium. If you have a speaker, it would totaling to $2,000, it must be equal to $10,000. So we could see the feasibility, of course, and the timelines, delivery of your outputs. Okay, and lastly, the last part of the template, the proposal template, is telling us how you will monitor and evaluate the successes of your project. What would be your regular action to set up the milestones, the success indicators to measure that, so that we know if your outcomes and objectives are being achieved. And of course, we would want to know your plans for sustainability. How do you plan to sustain this project beyond the $10,000 grant? The last part, as you can see below, is optional. It's not required. But please, if you have a website, an existing social media page, a video, supporting photos, or any other information that we might need, so that we can further understand your project, please put the link in this portion. So it's not required, but if you already have that, especially for existing projects, if you already have videos and supporting photos, just to strengthen your case, please do send your link. Put it in the template. Okay, so where do we get the template? So how do we submit your proposal? So you submit your proposal to the CIMEO Secretariat using this Google link. Of course, link.cimeo.org/2023-submission. Okay, or you can scan the QR code it flashed on the screen before October 20, 2023. We have already received actually some proposals when we launched them last week, and we are excited to receive more after this orientation. So please do come back in this YouTube live or YouTube video so that you can further flesh out the details if you have any clarifications so that you can start submitting. So we have submitted, I think, around 3 proposals over the weekend after the launch. It's quite interesting and quite exciting, actually. Also, please note that proposals sent to the email address sa ella@simeo.org will not be accepted. We will be answering your questions via this email address, but submission should be via this link and this QR code. Individuals can submit their proposal related to the themes starting last weekend, starting last September 15, and will end on the midnight of October 20, 2023. As mentioned, some countries already submitted their proposals, so please keep them coming. And I hope this orientation session will be a catalyst for you to submit more. Each person may submit only one proposal. So we would be checking if you've submitted 2 proposals, because only one proposal will only consider one proposal to be part of the evaluated. Okay, so I hope you're all prepared on how to submit in preparing your proposals. Now, after you submitted your proposals, how will we select the winner? Okay, so first, the selection and evaluation of entries will be conducted by a committee comprised of experts from Southeast Asia and representatives from relevant international organizations, CIMEO Secretariat, CIMEO Regional Centers, and the Australian government. And this is how we will be selecting the winner. So this, you can see the criteria for the selection of winner. First, 25% is on innovation, practicality, and originality. What are we looking for here? We will look at the originality, innovativeness, and feasibility of implementation of the proposed project, which of course aligns to the theme. So we value originality. Something that we have not seen before is very much appreciated in Sa ELA 2023. This comprises 25% of your total score. Second, we would look at the benefit and relevance to Southeast Asia and links to Australia, which is 30% of your total score. We want to see the extent to which the proposal will contribute to social value, benefit the region, and enhance mutual understanding. This includes the transfer of new ideas, expanded educational opportunities, improved education quality, and long-term people-to-people connections. We want to see how this project proposal, this project that you are proposing, will move forward inclusion and digitalization in the region. Of course, we will always go back to the theme, fostering inclusion through digital technology. That's 30%. The next for 25% is the value for money and sustainability. We will see how well the project proposal demonstrates value for money and its sustainability beyond the initial grant funding. So if you can remember, we looked at the implementation plan, the cost that you will be proposing. We're also looking at your plans for sustainability. How will you ensure that this is not just one-off, that even after Sa ELA, this will continue and something that the community will benefit from? That's 25%. And then lastly, we will be looking at potential for replication and scaling up, which is 20%. We will look at the extent to which the project or proposal can be scaled up and applied to other contexts. So that's why we really looking forward to the proposals which includes other countries, because this means that this project can be scaled up or replicated in other contexts as well. So that's why we would want to see that highlighted in your project proposal. Of course, this will add up to 100%. And the winner, the one with the highest scores from all our judges and evaluation committee, will be the winner, only one winner, of the Sa ELA 2023. I hope that was clear and you're all excited in preparing your project proposals. Okay, please take note of the dates flashed on your screen. The deadline is on October 20, midnight of October 20, and we will be announcing the winners on November 15, after the entry evaluation shortlisting and evaluation committee meeting, directly after the deadline for entry of submission this October. And the awarding ceremony. We will hope to see you here in Bank of Thailand on November 29 for the awarding ceremony of the 2023 Simeo Australia Education Links Award. Okay. Please do visit the link.simeo.org/2023saela for more details. And of course, if you download the template, if you scan this QR code, you will be directed to the webpage of the 2023 Saela. And of course, the template where you can download it and put in your project proposals and upload it via the submission link that we showed earlier. And all the information that I've just mentioned will also be there in our webpage. Okay, before we answer your questions, let us share with you the progress video of the Saela 2022 winner under the theme Building Back Better Through Partnership. Our winner was Dr. Elga Andriana, Head of International Undergraduate Program, researcher at the Center for Lifespan Development, CLSD, a faculty of psychology of the Universitas Gajah Mada from Indonesia. Her project is entitled Our Photo Voice, Children and Young People's Joint Action Research on Student Wellbeing for All. Let us watch this video.
COVID-19 pandemic has impacted negatively on students' well-being. This project aims to support students to rebuild their social, emotional, and cognitive well-being by involving children and young people as researchers. In this project, we will form three groups of children and young people from Yogyakarta, Kupang, and Jambi as young researchers. The young researchers will receive training on research, photo voice method, and well-being. They will investigate children's well-being using photo voice, which allow them to take photos that represent strength and concern within students' well-being and discuss them with our mentors. Photo voice also allows them to practice well-being such as attention, emotional awareness, self-awareness, introspection, kindness, and compassion. They will present their findings at child-led webinar 1 and suggest ways of addressing the concerns by achievable action plans. They will implement the action plans collaboratively with mentors, teachers, and parents. At the end of the project, the young researchers will present the result at child-led webinar 2 to facilitate them as active agents for well-being recovery to wider communities. From this project, we also aim to yield 5 expected outputs, including young researchers groups in each location, virtual photo voice exhibition, ebook on supporting children's well-being written by mentors, parents, and teachers, ebook written by young researchers entitled Our Voice, Our Well-being, and a journal article written by project collaborators.
Hi, I'm Johanna. I represent Rimba Child from Jambi. We just finished the first event child webinar for a photo voice activity that tell about our well-being. We were very nervous because we had never been presenters before. But after practice passionately with our friends, finally we can do it. We are proud to be able to tell our situation in the process of getting an education to many people. Thank you, Simeo, Saela.
Thank you.
our 2022 winner, Dr. Elga Andriana. What a wonderful way to engage the children and youth to enhance their well-being. So this is an example of how we can utilize or leverage cooperation and collaboration between communities, in this instance, researchers and the young children, the people in the community. So we hope that this video has inspired you as you develop your project proposals. Okay, so now let us answer some questions. And we only have one question, actually, so I hope everything is clear. The question comes from Fajri Koto. I have an inquiry regarding the proposal's author for the 2023 CIMEIO Australia Education Links Award. Can it be submitted by a team of two individuals? So, Fajri, this year's CELA, only one proponent will be acknowledged. But please don't hesitate to involve other actors, your partner, for example, so that they will be involved in the implementation. But the award, the flight to Bangkok, and the other awards will be, the plaque of recognition will be acknowledged only to one proponent for this year. So please don't hesitate to still involve other actors. It's part of your implementation plan, so that we can highlight the importance of collaboration and cooperation. We hope that answered your question, Fajri. Okay. So if there are no other questions for this orientation session, we hope we have clarified it and more inspired. You have more inspired and encouraged to join this year's CELA. And before we officially end, may I call once again our Deputy Director for Program and Development, Mr. John Arnold Shena, for a closing remarks. Mr. John?
Thank you very much, Kun Emil. As we come to the end of this orientation, I want to express my heartfelt gratitude to each one of you. Your presence here today signifies your commitment to the cause of fostering inclusion through digital technology in Southeast Asia, and it fills us with great optimism for the future. We've covered a lot of ground during this session, and I hope you found the information shared here by Kun Emil very valuable and relevant as you prepare your proposals for CELA 2023. As you design your project proposals and the impact they can have on our region's education landscape, I encourage you to remember that CELA is not just an award program, it's a platform for change. So your projects, ideas, and innovations have the potential to transform your respective communities, to empower marginalized communities, and to address barriers to inclusion. Indeed, this is just the beginning of your journey and our journey together. As you work on your project proposals, we will be here to support you every step of the way. I urge you to reach out to our team if you have any questions or you need guidance during the application process. In closing, I want to once again thank you for your dedication, your passion, and your commitment to the cause of fostering inclusion through digital technology. I would also like to express our deepest gratitude to the Australian Government Department of Education for the continued support and partnership in advancing inclusion and digital transformation in the region. I wish you all the best as you start this exciting journey, and I look forward to seeing your innovative project proposals. Thank you and have a wonderful day ahead.
Thank you very much, Mr. John, for encouraging our participants and also reminding them that what they do and will be doing is for the learners of our region. We would like to thank once again Australian Government Department of Education for your partnership, which is a prime example actually of cooperation and collaboration towards achieving shared visions. And that concludes our orientation session. This session will be up on our YouTube channel, so please feel free to watch again if you have any other clarification, if you missed some points, or share with other interested colleagues. Please visit us at www.cimeio.org for other programs and, of course, for the details of CELA 2023. Thank you very much, and may the rest of your day be wonderful.